friends, it's Melissa here from Melissa Shares, and welcome to my channel, or welcome back. With Mother's Day coming up and the summer and warm months approaching, I wanted to talk to you about three old-fashioned foods that happen to also be foods that my grandmothers made that are no-cook, frugal, and beautiful dishes that I feel have fallen out of favor or out of vogue, but that are worth bringing back. So let's get started. The first one is my paternal grandmother's recipe for curried coleslaw. And if you don't like curry, that's fine. It can be omitted and you can still make this recipe. All that you need for this recipe is a bag of coleslaw mix or cabbage and carrot that you slice yourself, frozen peas, Spanish peanuts, curry powder, and mayonnaise. You mix these items to taste, and what I love about this coleslaw is that it does remind me of my grandma. It is an unconventional coleslaw to serve, and it is super delicious. So you get the crunch of your coleslaw with the sweetness of your peas, with the crunch of your peanuts, and somehow that peanut and curry flavor really goes together great. And my grandmother always garnished it this certain way with like a ring around the edge that was so, so beautiful. So curried coleslaw is my first vintage retro recipe that reminds me of my grandma that I think is worth bringing back, and no cooking is required. It's also a really economical, easy recipe to make. My second recipe that reminds me of my grandmother's is on my maternal grandmother's side, layered salads. And you may be familiar with the layered salad where it's topped with frozen peas and capped with a layer of mayonnaise to kind of lock everything in, and a little bit of sugar. And my family definitely made that kind of layered salad. In my updated version, I recently made this salad for my family and it met rave reviews. So I was so glad that I brought it back. I updated this layered salad using some of these items here. I used bagged coleslaw mix on the bottom. I added things like celery. You can put in chopped peppers. I had a layer of goat cheese. I added a layer of sliced strawberries that I happen to have on hand. I do like to put frozen peas in my layered salad. And then I eventually topped it off with some beautiful pansies, or you could use another edible flower from the garden. And it was so beautiful, you guys. You serve your layered salad in a clear glass bowl so that you can see all of those gorgeous layers. Consider updating a layered salad with some other kind of higher end items if you'd like: avocado, hearts of palm, a canned rinsed bean, and it will be the hit of the party if you take this to a potluck or a picnic. It can be really healthy and really refreshing for the warm months. My last recipe that I think is worth bringing back, and especially in the warm summer season, is Jell-O molds. Jell-O molds, I think, get a bad rap, but I was definitely raised on family functions with Jell-O molds. My paternal grandmother had a raspberry lemon Jell-O mold that she made with crushed pineapple, sour cream, and frozen raspberries, and that still is a Jell-O mold that I love to make. For a healthier version, I like to do a Jell-O mold that uses the unflavored gelatin packets, and I can list my recipe for this down below. You basically are gonna follow the instructions on your gelatin packet. I used canned fruit in its juice and fruit nectar to make a really refreshing Jell-O mold with no added sugar. So just using the natural sugars of your fruit juices. This was a recipe that I pulled off with no advanced planning, just looking into my cupboard to see what I had. I know that all families have their sentimental foods. I have a lot of food memories of these dishes being served at family functions. They are old-fashioned foods. Depending on where you're from, your family may or may not have made these if you're, you know, from a different part of the world. So I wanted to share these like very American mid-century recipes that I really love and feel nostalgic about. I love that they are frugal and easy to put together, and they don't require you to turn on your oven. Thank you so much for watching today. If you like this video, let me know. Leave a comment down below. I hope you have a really wonderful Mother's Day weekend and a wonderful summer. And let me know if you plan on trying out any of these recipes. Take care.